the Lord.
Thank you.
hands together and give God a great praise. I said, if we can put our hands together and give God a great praise, I will bless the Lord at all times. I will bless the Lord at all times. Though I may be heavy in spirit, I will bless the Lord at all times. And his praise shall continually be in my mouth. Come on, clap your hands in this place and give God praise. I said, clap your hands in this place and give God praise. I said, clap your hands in this place and give God praise. How do you know for the spirit of heaviness, God will give you a garment of praise? Amen. We come to praise him on today. I said, we come to praise him on today. I said, we come to praise him on today. Amen. He's worthy to be praised. He's worthy to be praised. One more time, let's give God a great praise in this place. I don't know what God y'all serve, but my God deserves a great praise. I said, let's give God a praise for the life of Miss Jazzy. Come on, let's give God praise for what he's given us. Let's give God praise for what he's lent us. Let's give God praise for the love he gave us through her. Come on and lift him up, y'all. Come on and lift him up. He said, if I'll be lifted up, I'll draw all men unto thee. He said, if I be lifted up, I'll give you strength. He said, if I be lifted up, I'll give you joy. Let's give God a praise. You may be seated. We come to praise him, y'all. I said, we come to praise him. I didn't come to pump or pry you. Amen. But I know God is worthy, and he's worthy to be praised. My cousin says she wanted to praise God. So that's what we're going to do. Amen. For the spirit of heaviness, God said he'll give you a garment of praise. How many know praise? Praise when you don't feel like it. Praise makes things all right. How many know the more you praise him, the better you'll feel? The more you praise him, the more he'll give you strength. The more you praise him, the more he'll lift you up. The more you praise him. Right. We're going to move on this service. Amen. At this time, we're going to have the prayer of comfort by Elder James Cupperson. Followed by that, we're going to have the scripture reading, the New Testament, St. John 14, verses 1 through 4. Deacon Jimmy Stewart. After that, we will have a musical selection in that order. Come on, clap your hands and encourage them as they come.
Let us bow our heads. Most gracious and heavenly Father, we come humbly before your throne of grace, asking you to comfort and strengthen this family as they go through their time of bereavement, Lord. We ask you, Lord God, to help them to remember the
brothers. Can you turn these monitors up right here for me? The battle's not yours. Come on, clap your hands and give God praise. If you know the battle's not yours, it belongs to God. Amen. We're going to have a poem this time by Sister Brenda Wooten. Amen. Brenda Wooten, if you can, to my right, your left, that podium right there. Let's give her some love. Clap your hands, y'all.
Dreams last night, and if I could have, I would have run to you and held you tight because I wasn't ready to let you go. That smile, that glow, that walk in the room like you already know I'm that girl. Her baby, her world, his, you made me a daddy first. Her, somebody I could talk to when I'm feeling my worst. Her mother. Girl, I heard you in my room last night. And I wish that I could have run to you and held you tight because I ain't ready to let you go. That laugh, that glow, that dress better than anybody I know. If I don't answer in a minute, she gonna show up at my door. Her big sister, her bestie, my big cousin, my big stepping, big cussing, big cousin, that girl. I'll fly as the highest light, shake up the room, wake up the night. I'll bring all the energy with me. Positivity is me, flashy, jazzy girl. I swear, I felt you with me last night, gifting me with your presence through my tears, letting me know you're gonna always be here. So if you can hear us right here, right now, there's something you should know. That smile, that laugh, that vibe, that glow, we ain't gonna never let it go. Sister girls for life.
This time we're going to come to reflections, and as you see on the program, it says please limit to 2 minutes. 2 minutes. Now I know that's hard for many of us, but you have to do that on today. Is that all right? So if you go over your 2 minutes, I'm going to stand up. That means it's time for you to finish. We have a couple of names on the program. Maybe we want to get through it expeditiously. Amen. So at this time, we're going to ask, as a best friend, Nikki to come. As a cousin, Toya. As a cousin, Micaiah. I'm sorry, Jessica. I'm going to ask those three to come at this time. As a best friend, as a cousin, and as a cousin, okay? Let's give them some love, y'all.
My name is
will do is refrain from saying what she was, because she is.
Best friend and two cousins. At this time, I want everyone to stand except for the immediate family as we receive, man, Jazzy's daughter, her granddaughter, and her bonus daughter. So we're going to call this time, stand up on your feet, everybody. Amen. Let's receive her daughter, Micaiah, her granddaughter, Brooke, and her bonus daughter, Kia. Come on, y'all. Let's show them some love by clapping your hands. Come on, show some love, y'all. This is her mother, their mother, grandmother. Amen. Come on, show them some love as they come and reflect on their mother.
Sister, because I'm not quite sure if I know how to do that, being that I never introduced Nena to the world, my friends, my associates, as my god sister. I always introduced her as my sister, and she always did the same in return. The world knew her as Jazzy, I knew her as Nena. And she used to get on me all the time about that when she used to go out and she'll run across people that I knew and they'll call her Nena. She'll text real quick and say, you got these people in the club calling me and they're like, they know me. And I reply, but you answered though. And she's like, yeah, I did. I wrote it down, but it's still hard to. Last time I was in a room full of people with you in my presence, Nana, it was brought to my attention that I didn't acknowledge you. It was never something that was intentional. So as I stand here today, knowing that this will be the last time standing in a crowded room with you, I don't want to miss the opportunity again. Because there's something about that word, that time, you know, the word time, and we take it for granted. Nina, I thank you. I thank you. It's just a very small word for all that you did for me, for us as a big sister. The love, the guidance, our talks, the memories, the laughter, your fashion sense, the clubbing very early, and the correction you provided me. When I did act up in public, you never corrected me in public. You always pulled me to the side, and you always did it in private, and you told me exactly what I needed to do. And I know it's true because someone prior to said it as well. I walked into this family 20 plus years ago in Myrtle Grove. Never heard of Myrtle Grove. Mama took me in. I walked on the steps with nothing, but you provided me with everything. You never questioned Mama's judgment. You just said, come on in, sis. And your actions, they provided me with something no one else could or can. I thank you and I love you for that and for that. And rest assured, our secrets will always stay safe with me until I rest, as you did mine as you were here. I love you, Nina.
Come on, y'all, let's clap your hands one more time for her daughters, her bonus sisters. Amen. At this time, I'm going to ask you to stand again. I'm going to make y'all exercise today because y'all act like y'all sleep. The family's coming one more time, but I want the immediate family to sit. But let's receive her two beautiful sisters as they come and give reflections on their sister, their big sister. Come on, let's give Frederica and Rashida a hand, y'all. Come on, let's show some love. Come on, keep clapping as they come. Come on, keep clapping. There's strength when you clap. There's strength when you encourage. There's strength when you push. Amen. Come on, let's push them. They need all the love right now. That's right. Come on, keep clapping till they come. Come on, come on. That's it. Clap, clap, clap. Man, you may be seated.
Said our final goodbyes to my brother. During his service, I watched my mom with a broken heart thank God over and over again for the time he had given us him. I didn't understand it at that time because I was angry. 10 years later today, I stand here yet again, but I get it now. And I thank you, God. I now understand the harrowing cries and praise in the midst of a broken heart. Thank you, God. I understand the gift of time. I thank you for the time you have given us. Thank you, God. My sister was everything. She was beautiful with the biggest heart and smile. She was loving, she was loyal, and she was full of life. She loved us. She made us a priority and would always find things for us to do together just to spend time with us. We were SBFL. I can't say what that means right now, but if you know, you know. Our bond was deep, pure, and it provided safety. We were not perfect by any means, but we forgave quickly, and we made up over drinks and laughter. She was my best friend. She was my best friend. When I suffered from deep depression, she saved me. She came and she was with me. She didn't leave my side. Up until February 23rd, she still found ways to save me. She'd come in the middle of the night to be with me. Didn't matter the time. Didn't matter why I was calling. She showed up. Some days I didn't have words and we would just lay on the couch in silence. She was there. Her being there said everything that wasn't said. She held all my secrets and she never made me feel silly for sometimes not making the right decisions. She always assured me that I knew what was best and she encouraged me to trust that. My sister taught me how to be confident and how to live for now. In all the ways that she loved me, I loved her back. Whenever she needed me, I was there. There was nothing I would not do for her. She valued my opinion, and she often sought out advice from me on how to approach different life situations and guidances in her business. I secretly felt honored that she regarded me the way that she did. She was my biggest supporter. She was always so proud of me, and she cheered me on. There is so much I'm gonna miss about her. We really enjoyed life together. It was never a dull moment. Our sister days were magical. They kept me grounded. And it was then that I was the happiest. We have memories to last an eternity. Thank you, God, for 41 years of lessons, laughter, and love. Thank you for 44 years of her life.
Thank you, Lord.
My sister knew that I loved her. my actions were always in alignment with the many I love yous that we shared. I encourage everyone here today to cherish the time you have with the ones you love now while they are here. Laugh as hard as you can and forgive quickly. We had an entire year of our monthly sister dates planned, like literally, because we thought we had time. Life is a constant reminder of Isaiah 55, verses 8 through 9. My plans are not your plans, nor are your ways my ways, says the Lord. Just as the heavens are higher than the earth, so are my ways higher than your ways, and my plans than your plans. I leave here today with no regrets. My sister knew I loved her. I loved her deeply, and I gave the best that I could of myself to her while she was here. Thank you.
Man, come on, keep clapping your hands while they're going to the seats. That was beautiful. Amen. At this time, we're going to receive Mime Dance from Brother David Ruffin. Come on, clap your hands and encourage him as he comes.
This is what I need you to do.
Fight this battle.
Fight this battle.
Come on, y'all, let's lift our hands in the sanctuary. Come on, let's lift our hands in the sanctuary. Come on, lift your hands and receive strength from God on this morning. Look at your neighbor and say, we've won again. Come on, say, my name is victory. Come on, say, my name is victory. Victory is ours today. Come on and give them some praise. Come on, receive strength from God because we've won again. The devil is a liar. God will be exalted. Hallelujah. We've won again. My name is victory. And we say thank you, Lord. We say thank you, Lord. We say hallelujah anyhow. We say hallelujah anyhow. If we couldn't even say a word, we'll just wave our hands. We'll just wave our hands and surrender to you, God. We've won again. We've won again. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let's give God praise for Brother Brandon Ruffin one more time for that mime dance. At this time, turn your attentions to the screen. We will have a video tribute for the life of Miss Melinda Jazzy. Come on and give God praise for the video tribute.
Oh.
Of Melinda Jazzy. Come on, clap your hands one more time. Listen, if Melinda has loved on you any kind of way, any special way, done something for you, impacted your life, give God a praise for that. I said, give God a praise for that. But then while you're clapping your hands, just say, thank you, Lord. Come on, thank you, Lord. Our ways are not his ways, but thank you, Lord. Oh, we'll understand it better by and by, but thank you, Lord. Thank you, thank you. Thank you, God, because she didn't die full. She died empty. Amen. I said she died empty, y'all. I said she died empty. She gave all that she could give. She loved all that she could. She died empty. That's enough to give God praise. Hallelujah. Amen. We thank God again for her life. And her life will forever live. It will forever live. Amen. This time we have acknowledgement. Amen. We're going to ask if Michael Williams Funeral Home will come at this time with acknowledgement. Come on, let's give this beautiful staff a hand. Family has entrusted.
The hymnologist picked up his pen and was not afraid to pen the words that says, "Pass me not, O gentle Savior. Hear my humble cry, for while on others thou art calling, Master, do not pass me by." For you see, on the other day, Jazzy came to to Jesus just as she was, tired, weary, worn, but not sad. And in him, I'm sure she found a resting place. Daughter's mom, dad, and he has made her glad. To Bishop Curry in his absence, the New Birth Cathedral of Faith, Elder Cupperson, Elder McMillan, Minister Stanley, all the other ministers who are in the house, but most of all to you, the many dear friends, are taking the time out to be with the family. They'll have us, the Michael Williams Funeral Home staff, to say thank you for your letters, your cards, your prayers, your emails, but most of all, your beautiful floral remembrances. At a later date, when the time is more opportune and the family is more composed, we'll have I'm sure they'll thank you in a more personal manner. And now we'll have presentations of your beautiful floral remembrances. For flowers say so much in times like these. This lovely standard spray on easel says, words seem to be inadequate to express the sadness that we feel of Jazzy's death. We are here to support you in the grieving process. Our sincere sympathy, the towers of Quayside. If you learn just to hold on, just a little while longer, I'm sure everything would be all right.
Mavis and Donnie.
Saying it again through flowers, this lovely basket arrangement. We send our heartfelt and condolences to you during this most difficult time. We all are saddened by the loss. Your co-workers at Covanta.
This beautiful arrangement simply says, may the peace which comes from the memories of loved ones shared comfort you now know and in days ahead with heartfelt sympathy, Tyrone and family.
I've had some good days. I've had some hills to climb. But the hymn artist went on down in the song and says, I simply won't complain. This lovely standing arrangement, the symbol of the bleeding heart, and love and memory of Big Jazzy. What the heart has once known, it shall never be forgotten. We will always love you from Kalia and Pooh.
This beautiful arrangement on the easel simply says, our thoughts and prayers are with you, Rashida and family, with love, Rayshawn, Ingram, and family.
This lovely basket arrangement, the peace lily, your loving brother, you will truly be missed. Devin, Shaquille, Kyle, and Tremaine.
This beautiful arrangement comes with we extend our deepest condolences and prayers to you. May the peace and strength of God be with you and your family, Pastor Wayne Lomax and the Fountain Church.
Proverbs 3:5 says, lean not to your own understanding, but in all your ways acknowledge him, and he will direct your path. Saying it again through flowers, we send our prayers and condolences to you with love from Carol and Tim Michael.
Simply from a friend. Asking comes to Malia Makia. Our hearts go out to you in the time of sorrow from Chi Chi and Eric Van Dyke and your Nana.
I love when the deacons raise the hymn, won't it be grand? Won't it be grand? Then he goes down and say, when I see Jesus, won't it be grand? You have our deepest condolences during this loss. May God peace comfort you and your family, Connie and family.
This beautiful heart comes. Death leaves a heartache no one can heal. Love leaves a memory no one can steal. Forever in our hearts. Yakima from Roscoe, hashtag TPB.
verse 4, blessed are those who mourn, for they shall be comforted. In loving memory of Jazz from Reese, Rob, team, play your part.
This beautiful arrangement comes with love and remembrance. You will always and forever be in our hearts. Love from Jean, Patricia, Gary, Maria, Shatonda, Michelle, Makaira, Sebastian, Nikisha, Jasmine, Irina, Anaya, Philip, Elena, and Amon.
And these lovely bouquet of flowers comes with love from T.S.A.
To break, this was shocking to me. To the family, hold your head up and just know that Melinda is now with Warren. From Festa, Kelsey, and Quincy, we are sending our deepest condolences.
The two basket arrangements. We love and miss you. We will carry you forever in our hearts. Love, Desi and Kaya. Symbol of the bleeding heart literally says, daughter, we will miss you. How can we help but to cry? Go on, take your rest. We'll see you by and by. It comes from her mom and dad. In our closing, just before she sings, I'm reminded of a story of a young lady and a preacher. They were on their way from revival and they encountered a storm on the way home, and the daughter looked up at her dad and said, Dad, should we stop driving while in the midst of the storm? He looked over into her and said, baby, just keep on driving. While driving, they encountered some other vehicles pulled on the side of the road with their flashes on, and she said, Daddy, I can't see anymore. Should I pull over here and wait till the storm pass? Daddy said, no, baby, just keep on driving. She kept driving and kept driving, and she says, Daddy, now I'm about to lose traction under these tires. He said, baby, just slow down the car and keep on driving. Well, eventually, she kept driving, and once she got out of the storm, she looked back, dad looked back and said, now look back. You see all those people you left in the storm? You made it out. So all I'm telling you, family, is Jazzy encountered a storm called death. She looked back over her life and said, I don't want to come back to this old mean, cruel world. So she just kept on going with Jesus until her now final resting place, for she's now going home to see the King. There are no more sad songs, parties, heartaches for Jazz to sing. She's now going home to the perfect life. She's now going home to live with Christ. But then you'll find her around God's throne. Never ever shall she be alone, for daughters, mothers, sisters, and friends. There's no need to worry. Co-workers, there's no need to fear, for she's now secured in God's care. But God promised each and every one of us that when he went away, he was coming back yet again on another day. For Melinda has lived her life 44 great years, so full of grace. Now God and only God has granted her an eternal resting place. But for each of us who've left behind, I like to leave these kind words to ever fulfill your mind. That is, if we learn how to serve God and pray, I'm sure we'll see Melinda, Jazzy, Buckner again on another day. May God bless and keep you is our sincere prayer.
I don't know about tomorrow. I just live from day to day. I don't borrow from its sunshine, for its sky may turn to gray, and I don't worry about my future, for I know what Jesus said, and today He walks beside me, for He knows what lies ahead. Many things about tomorrow
for the acknowledgments and the selection. Amen. This time we want to acknowledge the Victory Community Church. Amen. They submitted a resolution of Victory Community Church. Reverend Otis Pettaway is the senior pastor there. We also ask everyone that from class of 1996, Carroll High School, if you will stand, let's acknowledge you at this time. Amen. Carroll City High School, if you attended Carroll City High School, stand up, clap your hands for them. Amen. This is the high school where she graduated. We thank you. Amen. At this time, the scripture declares that man should not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeds out of the mouth of God. Amen. After this final music selection, we're going to ask everyone to stand once more, except for the immediate family, and receive, amen, our sister's brother, Minister Devin Stanley, and from the Macedonia Baptist Church. He's going to come with words of life after this final musical selection in that order. Amen. Come on, clap your hands for this last musical selection.
I'm not even sure what time it is at this point, so I'm just going to say good morning and good afternoon to everybody. It's amazing how I can do these services every week for the past 24 years of my life since I was a little boy. And people may think that, you know, I have developed this defense mechanism as if I don't
remember those walls are built. Well, baby, they're tumbling down. And they didn't even put up a fight. They didn't even make a sound. I found a way to let you in, but I never really had a doubt. Standing in the light of your halo, I've got my angel now. It's like I've been awakened, and every rule I had you breaking. And it's a risk that I'm taking, and I ain't never gonna shut you out. Cause everywhere we're looking now, I'm surrounded by your embrace. And then I can feel your halo. You know you're my saving grace. You're everything I need and more. It's written all over my face. And then I can feel your halo. I pray it won't fade away. 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 Don't fade away. Don't fade away. Don't fade away. If I should stay, I would only be in your way. So I'll go, but I know I'll think of you every step of the way. And yeah. with life, treat you kind, and I hope you have all you dreamed of. And I wish you joy and happiness, but above all this, I wish you love and I. I will always, always love you, Nana, Nana, want you to know, I will always love you, ooh, ooh. I will always
battled with changed. Her love remained. It was impossible for her to change. So that's why I celebrate my sister, my baby big sister, the first girl that I've ever unconditionally loved. I'm reminded of a story I was telling Kaya the other day. I was trying to tell her a long time ago. I called Melinda up and I was like, I'm gonna take the girls out to Chuck E. Cheese. They old enough to talk, but probably not old enough to remember. And to myself, I'm wondering, okay, is Caitlin, Alicia, Caitlin was a baby at the time, Destiny and Kaya. And I'm like, okay, this is easy, it's just four girls. So we go on our way to Chuck E. Cheese. I can't remember who started the conversation, but it was either Desi or Kaya. They asked Alicia, they said, Alicia, are you my friend? And Alicia said, yeah. And then Alicia asked them back, are you my friend? And they said, yeah. And so now I think it's Kaya's turn. Alicia, are you my friend? She says, yeah. Alicia said, you my friend? Yeah. So in the front seat, I'm like, okay, now that we have established protocol, we can go to Chuck E. Cheese. So they went. They ran all over the place, fell out, had a good time. On the way back, one of them asked, hey, you still my friend? And Alicia said, yeah. Are you still Kaya's friend? And she was like, yeah. And then I think it was Desi started this conversation. She was like, well, you're not my friend. So then they went in their rounds. Well, then it was Kaya's turn. Well, if you Desi friend, you're not my friend. And then Alicia, same thing. So about 10 minutes in the trip, they fell out. And then right after that, they fell asleep. And I'm cracking up to myself because those little girls taught me a lesson. One, females are very possessive about those who they love. And they don't want to share you with anybody. And if they find out that they have to share you with anyone, not only will they fall out with you, but they won't lose any sleep. And then I realized it takes a special person to touch a group of individuals and keep them connected in perfect harmony. And that's what Melinda is. She's touched so many lives, so many individuals, and kept them connected. Do y'all know how much drama that can bring? Because you can't do this and be phony. Somebody, I don't know if I stepped on a toe. But you can't do that and be phony. Do you know how many secrets that you have to keep in order to keep a group of individuals connected? So when I say we're celebrating the transition of a queen, she was truly a queen, and she took so many secrets with her. I know I'm pressed for time, so I'm gonna read out a scripture, and Holy Spirit, have your way with me today. I do wanna thank all of the ministers. Thank you, Michael, you've done such an excellent job. Give him a round of applause, please. I question God a lot. He's been dealing with me since the 23rd. And sometimes we feel guilty about questioning God. But I want you all to understand the Bible that I read says, ask. receive. Christ, when he went to Gethsemane, he said, Father, let this cup pass from me. And if it wasn't enough, he accepted his answer. But then when he gets to the cross, he doesn't even have enough strength to call him Father. He says, my God, why? And sometimes we have why, and I just hear God saying, I can't give you the why if you don't understand the what. Because if I tried to tell you why and you don't know the what, you don't know how to interpret my answer, or you may not believe that I have answered you at all. And so I question God, and I'm like, God, what? What is it? And he led me to a scripture and a couple of scriptures, but Ecclesiastes 12, verse 7, I know we don't bring our Bibles to homegoings, so I'll read it. But in Ecclesiastes 12, verse 7, the Bible says, then shall the dust return to the earth as it was, and the spirit shall return unto God who gave it. If you follow me, let's go to Genesis chapter 1. We'll end up at Ecclesiastes, but Genesis chapter 1, verse 26. And for a few minutes, I'll speak on this topic. Genesis chapter 1, beginning at verse 26, the Bible says, and God said, let us make man in our image, after our likeness, and let them have dominion over the fish of the sea, and over the fowl of the air, and over the cattle, and over all the earth, and over every creeping thing that creepeth upon the earth. Verse 27, so God created man in his own image. In the image of God created he him. In the image of God created he him. In the image of God created he him. Understand that you are in the image of God. You have the image of God, not an identity crisis. In the image of God created he him. Male and female created he them. And God blessed them. And God said unto them, be fruitful and multiply, and replenish the earth and subdue it, and have dominion over the fish of the sea, and over the fowl of the air, and over every living thing that moveth upon the earth. Just for a few minutes, I want to talk to you all. I know we do religion a lot, and we have a lot of titles. I'm not too keen on titles. Even when you read the obituary, they have minister. I really don't care for titles. I've met a lot of prophets, lot of pastors, lot of preachers, lot of whatever, but I've noticed in religion, this is the one place where you can have a title and a story don't match. But I'll give you a title today. It's called, I Have an Assignment. I have an assignment. Throughout the Bible, you see illustrations of where God disrupts the lives of the individuals he has called to serve him. We see it in the book of Genesis with Abraham when he tells him, get thee from thy kindred. We see it in the book of Exodus with Moses when he calls him while he's on the backside of the mountain. We see it again with Jonah when he tells him to go down and preach. We also see it with Jeremiah the prophet while he was yet a little boy. But not only does he disrupt your lives in order to get your attention to answer his call, but he disrupts this thing that we use in philosophy called free will. See, the dilemma is man has developed a philosophy that says, and a theology that we have free will. Every day man does exactly what man wants to do. Out of all creations, that's why in Ecclesiastes he say, remember thy creator now. Because the sun never wakes up and decides he feels a little moonish. The moon has never moved since it was created. The earth, every day that you have waking up, the earth has continued to spin on its axis. But man is the only one that wakes up and say, I can do exactly or anything that I'm not designed to do. I can do what I decide to do as opposed to what I have been designed to do. And so that philosophy, we live by that. But I want to talk to the called folk. Because when you have a calling on your life, even when you want to do it, you can't do it. It's not that you don't desire to do it. Oh. It's not that you don't want to do it. It's just that God does what's called a divine disruption. And whenever you try to do wrong, you can't do wrong right. You will try to pop something with some milligrams on it and lose the whole